Face proportions tutorial. Here's a list of basic resources you may need.
Before starting any portrait, whether it's a self-portrait or the portrait of someone else, it's a good idea to have some knowledge of facial proportion. So have a go at drawing face shape on your page. If you're not confident with doing that, have a go at drawing a large arch at the top of your page and a smaller arch at the bottom, and then join them up. At this stage, it doesn't have to look like a realistic face shape, so please don't worry too much. Then draw a vertical line through the middle of your page or through the middle of your face. It doesn't have to be with a ruler, try and do it freehand. And then we need to do a line which is horizontal through the middle of the face, but this time it needs to be slightly curved. The reason for this is that our face is obviously on the front of our head, which is a spherical form. And if we were to draw a straight line, it would make our face look very flat and cartoon-like. Okay, now draw a line underneath the chin, and we're going to draw our eyes on this middle line here. So our eyes are roughly one eye's width apart. So you can draw that on your diagram. Two almond shapes. Remember that if you're drawing a person or drawing yourself, you would rely on your observation to make sure that the shape of your eyes were accurate. Okay, halfway between our eye line and our chin line, we're going to draw another curved line. Make sure that's halfway, and this is where our nose will sit. So I'm just going to draw on the shadows of our nose, very roughly. And that's where our nose would sit. Okay, halfway between our nose and our chin, roughly, is where our lips meet in the middle. So that's the shadow where our lips are meeting in the middle there, and the shadow underneath our bottom lip. Okay, you can add some detail to the eyes if you wish. I'll show you later how to add more detail to the features to make them look more realistic. Okay, so in line with our eyes and our nose is where you would see your ears. Have a little feel on your own face to see where those features are. We wouldn't see, if you were looking head on at a person, you wouldn't see much of the ear, but just draw that shape on there. And then if you have a feel at the base of your ear, you would feel where your neck begins. You don't see a lot of your neck because your face is in front of it. So it would curve in and then out again, like so. Now you're going to notice that there's a lot of space between the eyes and the top of the head. You can draw the eyebrows on if you wish. And then you can very roughly just draw on the hair. You don't necessarily need to draw the hair on. This is just to give you an idea of feature placement. But if you want to, you can. You want to add on some more detail to the eye, you can do. And there you have it. That is the facial the placement. So you have got an idea of where the eyes, the nose, the mouth, the ears and the neck all sit within a portrait. I'm going to show you how to draw an eye. Okay, so to draw an eye, the first thing you need to do is to very lightly with your pencil draw an almond shape or a lemon shape, so. And then you need to draw the iris. So the iris is the coloured part of your eye. If you take a look in the mirror, you will notice that you never really see the entire iris unless you are looking shocked or scared and your eyes are wide. So you need to cut the top off and the bottom. A good idea is to draw your eye shape and then draw the entire circle before using a rubber to take off the top and the bottom, and that's just going to allow you to keep the circular shape of the iris. Okay, so once you've done that and you're happy with the size in comparison to the rest of the eye, you can draw on your pupil. So your pupil, depending on how much light is getting into your eye, will either be quite large or quite small. I'm just going to draw my pupil. And then it's worth mentioning that a pupil is actually a hole in your eye, which is covered with a lens or cornea, which means that it's going to be very dark. So when you add your shade into any drawing, you're going to make sure you've got lots of really dark tones in your eye. You can use a rubber like I've just done to add any light to the eye as well. Okay, and then once you've got to that stage, you're going to start adding some detail to your iris. So if you look carefully in the mirror or a photograph, you'll notice that you have a darker area around the edge of your eye. So we're going to apply a little bit of pressure to show that darker area. And then everybody has a slightly different pattern on their iris. So I'm showing you how to draw a generic eye. But if you're drawing a self-portrait or if you're drawing a portrait of somebody else, you're going to want to look really carefully at the person that you're drawing to make sure that you're getting that the pattern accurate on the iris. Okay, so once you're happy with that, and try and blend in that line as well. So it's not an outline, it's part of the pattern, so you just want to try and blend that in as well. And you can use a sharp edge on your eraser or rubber to show some lighter areas in the eye as well. So if you've got a sort of a sharper edge on your rubber, you can show some more light areas as well. Okay, so once you've done that, we're going to draw on our top lid and our bottom lid. So depending on, again, who you're drawing, you might see more of the top lid or you might see less. Okay, bottom lid is, what we're going to do is we're going to draw the very fine line underneath where your eyelashes grow from. I'm going to draw that on, and this is a very, very thin line, so please make sure that your pencil is nice and sharp. And then once you've got to that stage, we can start adding some lashes. So you need to make sure that your pencil is nice and sharp, and then you're going to start adding your eyelashes as you see them. So it might be the case that you don't really see much of your lashes, and you need to remember that your lashes grow at different angles, so make sure that you're drawing them as you see them and draw each hair individually. Remember that they're not going all at the same angle. We want them to look realistic, so we're going to draw them as they grow. Okay, and then you need to add some eyelashes to the bottom lid also, and again going to draw them at the angle that we see them growing and not all going at the same angle. Okay, so as we know, your eye is a ball, so it's a spherical shape, so we need to make sure that that is reflected in our drawing. We need to show that it's a rounded form and it's not flat, so we need to actually show that in the shading. Make sure you're following that form round with your shading. If you use straight lines here, it's going to make your eyeball look flat and cartoon like so you want to show that it's spherical. tones to make some, give the appearance of depth. And that should match the dark tone of the pupil. And then lastly, just want to add in a little bit of detail where the tear duct is. There we are. Your eye. Okay, I'm going to show you how to draw a nose. So a nose is quite a tricky thing to draw. You need to remember that when we're drawing our facial features, what we're actually doing is we are recording our observations of what we can see. So our nose is a form, it's part of our face, so there is no outline. So we wouldn't draw our nose like this or like this, because we don't see any of these lines on our face. So what we're doing is we're looking at where the shadows fall on our face, and our nose has two shadows where our nostrils are, as they are holes. So this is where your darkest shading is going to be. And again, you need to make sure that you're looking at the person you're drawing, whether it's yourself or somebody else, and just make sure that you're getting the shape of those nostrils right. Okay, so once you've drawn your nostrils on and you press nice and hard, you can then look and see where the rest of the shading is on your nose, so where the shadows are. Okay, so you'll have some shading to the side of your nose, where your nose starts to lift away from your face. And then you might have a pointed nose or a button nose. So make sure again that you're looking to see where the shadows are. Okay, so you put the shadows in, and then you can start to vary the tone as well to make it look realistic. If your nose is slightly button like mine, put that mark in, and we're just trying to show the shadows on our face, okay? And you can start putting the shading on the nose as well, so. There we have it.